Oh man, I just poked myself in the eye. What do I just start? yeah, pickup video. I haven't made one in about a month. Now's my time to redeem myself. I've managed to pick up a couple of things over the last week. I haven't made a video on pickups because I just haven't actually had a chance to find anything or go out and go looking for stuff. But this week I've managed to redeem that. I haven't found anything amazing in terms of rarity, like freaking Fire Emblem and Ginkube, but I did manage to get a couple of good stuff for some really good prices in that. So I guess I'll start with this. I got a PS2 game which is called Lord of the Rings: The Third Age. I don't really care too much about Lord of the Rings. I've seen the films, but they're not really, it's not really a series that I'm a fan of that much. But yeah, I got this. The PS2 game itself is in really good condition. It looks like it's hardly even been opened. Or even used as well. So I got that. The reason why I bought it was because it was £2. It was in CEX, so you know, you get a PS2 game really cheap. I haven't really seen this tin before, so that was a pretty interesting find, I think. Next, I was in Watford getting some comics and stuff. I found a comic book shop in Watford, and they're pretty good. A little bit small, but it means I can keep up with my comics without having to order them online. So I was in Watford and I managed to get with this. It's a blue N64 controller with a rumble pack. I got these both as well for £2. They did have another N64 controller, but someone had cut the wire open and then extended it to an absurd amount. So it's something that, as handy as it is to have a long cable, it was too long, so I didn't really want it. So yeah, I got a blue N64 controller, nothing wrong with that. A really good price too, and I just dropped it on the floor. So that was the pickups during the week. This weekend I'm going to go to car boot sales. Just trying to think, trying to split this apart. What did I buy yesterday? Yesterday I managed to buy this. One of the few games that, there wasn't really that many games there, but I did manage to get this, Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater for the PlayStation 2. It's complete as well, so it comes with it's the advert for the Prima Guide, or whatever it is. The disc is in good condition as well, no problems with that. But the manual as well is in really good condition. It comes with the comic, which, by the way, I think looks absolutely horrible. I don't know why they decided to make it. It's got the, I can't remember the term for it now, but it's where they've got the dots all over the thing. It looks horrible because it's a 3D game, so it looks really off. So, yeah, I got Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater. Next up, I got one for myself and I got one for my nephew, but some person there was selling Mario toys for 50p each, so I've got these two. So I got one for my nephew so he can have one to mess around with. But yeah, 50p each for two Mario plushies, why not? I'm not really a fan of picking up plushies, to be honest, but because they were cheap, it's something that I may as well just pick up while I'm there. Next up, I got this, and you're probably wondering why, but it's actually a really, really freaking good PlayStation 1 analog controller. This here is my favourite PlayStation controller. I really do not like PlayStation 2 or PlayStation 3. I think the controllers are horrible. But PlayStation 1 analog, or PlayStation 2 DualShock analog as well is okay, but there's a few controllers that are off. Anyway, and PlayStation 3 is crap, but yeah, the analog PlayStation 1 controller, the DualShock, is a really good controller, mainly because of the triggers, which is actually R2 and L2. They work really well, and I really like the feel of this controller. It's got a nice weight to it. Still not as good as the Xbox 360 or GameCube controller, but I'd probably say it's my third favourite. The reason why I bought this, though, is because, one, it's in really damn good condition, and two, is because I can make use of these controllers with this. What this thing here is that when I go to fighting game tournaments, or just my local arcade, or if I'm at a friend's house and they've got a PlayStation 2, what you can do is this allows your Xbox or PlayStation 3 controller to then become console compatible with each other. So I've actually got, I mainly play on the Xbox. I've got one fight stick for my PlayStation 3, but I have multiple Xbox 360 controllers. But if I bring this, it means that I don't have to have a dual-modded Xbox Fight Stick, but I can actually use that one Xbox Fight Stick for either the Xbox or PlayStation 3. But at the end, in this part here, you would put the Xbox, it would save it, and then you would put in either, you know, then you can then use it on a PlayStation 3 or Xbox 360, so that's really handy. But as you can see here on the side, it also lets you plug in the PlayStation 1 controllers. So I can sync this to my Xbox 360, put this in, and then I can play an Xbox 360 with a PlayStation 1 controller. I've already tested it; it works perfectly fine. I was playing Dark Souls and Sonic the Hedgehog 2 in it just to give it a little bit of a taste. Taste, I mean test. And yeah, it works perfectly fine. It's good that I can still make use out of PlayStation 1 controllers, and these are definitely the ones worth picking up. So it's to me, when I buy this kind of controller, a car boot, I've now bought essentially a, and now I've got this for 50p. So to me, what I've done is I've essentially bought for 50p an Xbox 360 and a PlayStation 3 controller. So that, to me, that's a really good find. Getting them in really good condition, and the fact that I've essentially gotten a really cheap Xbox 360 controller. So thanks to this little box here that I've had for about a year and a half or so, it really lets you get the most out of PlayStation controllers. So that's my little talk on that. So yeah, that was Saturday's pickups. Today, Sunday's, I managed to get a couple. Nothing too special, but for £1 I got these three sealed PC games. They're from Grabit. I've seen these before. I think W. Smith used to sell these for some odd reason. Sega Rally PC Championship, I don't know what it is. Virtual Fighter, the first one. You'll have to be careful though, this requires a graphics card of 2 MB. Whoa. Don't want to blow up my processor. Wow, the processor is a 133 megahertz processor. Wow. That's like, I think calculators have got more than that. You need DirectX 7 or more to run Sonic R. That's the other one I picked up. Yeah, well, I mean, they're all sealed. Got them for a pound combined, so that's not too bad. One of the best pickups I actually got was Hotel Dusk, Room 215. This game here is, it's a hidden gem of the Nintendo DS library, much like the Phoenix Wright series, the Ghost Trick. It seems to be in that group of games, like the Phoenix Wright, Ghost Trick, and Hotel Dusk. In that it's a graphic novel style type game, or just a really solid game in general, and it's hard to explain, but you're playing as a detective, and it's all in a very, it's in drawn as a pencil art style, and you've got a couple of puzzles to solve. So I got this for £1. That's really good. It comes complete with the VIP stars as well. I already had this game, so it's, I've already got, I don't need to use the VIP stars, but yeah, it's a really good find. And I highly recommend you check this game out if you're interested in just playing a new DS game, and you want a hidden gem. Something also interesting to point out is that the sequel was released to this, and it's called The Last Window, I think. And that was only ever released in Japan and Europe. So if you ever see, and that game can go for around like 12 or so at minimum. Like you're looking at minimum of 10, but you can see it go for around 12, 15. So it's worth picking up the sequel to this game, just because it's uncommon in Europe, and it was only ever released in Japan and Europe. So if you're in America watching this, then you may want to check that game out as well, because you would not have gotten that game. So that was those four games. Speaking of getting a PlayStation controller, I actually managed to find this. It's a wireless PlayStation 2 controller, and this again I tested out. You would put, if I get the box again, it means that I can now plug this into here. And I now have a wireless PlayStation controller. I tested it on Dark Souls earlier today, and it works perfectly fine. I cannot find a single fault with it. I mean, the analog nubs made it a little bit of a clean, but overall, it works perfectly fine. I actually liked playing Dark Souls on this, maybe just a little bit more than the wired controller. Seems to have switched off. Yeah. So it's a wireless PlayStation controller, but again, it also means I've now received. Or received. I've actually bought a wireless Xbox and PlayStation 3 controller as well, because again, this thing here allows me to make use of it for two consoles. I've essentially gotten a really cheap, for 50p again, a wireless Xbox and PlayStation 3 controller. So I was really happy about that. And then the best part of the day, which unfortunately meant having to carry home, was yet again. Oh, it's all plugged in. I was testing it earlier today. Yet again, for £5, it didn't beat that £4.10 price that I got one for last time, but I managed to get another Wii for a fiver. I have no intention of keeping this again. This will be put on eBay as soon as this video is finished. So if you're interested, then you know, feel free to send me a message. It's going to be up for about 5 or so days. I sent I that Wii, that black Wii that I bought last time, I got it for £4.10 or so, and I sold it on eBay for £30. So I'm gonna do the exact same with this. It came with everything but the sensor bar. I'm not too sure why, but I can't complain. I got it for a fiver. But it also came with a Wii remote and nunchuck, and that's always a plus. So there's so to me, this was the highlight of the day, was getting a really cheap Wii. It hasn't been modded yet. I may end up modding this one. If the person on eBay wants me to mod it for them, then they can. I sold that black Wii on eBay last week, and the person wanted me to mod it for them. I did it free of charge because, you know, I'm not going to pay for that. So yeah, that was my little, actually, I guess little but big find of the day, and I'm really happy about getting another Wii because, you know, I can sell this again for a minimum of around £20 or so. And yeah, that was it for this week's pickups. I'm not too sure when I'm going to do another one. Again, it's just a spur of the moment type thing, depending on whether I go to Car Boots, but yeah. There's not much else to say, I don't think. But SGDQ was hype, if anyone was watching that. The speed one was awesome. And I can't wait. And I'm watching CEO at the moment. I'm actually watching D-Moon playing Wind Waker after SGDQ's just finished. But yeah, CEO 2014 is hype.